Hi, everybody. We're in Job. Before I get started, though, I wanted to let all of you know that from Bethel, that this morning I got a call that Dwayne Freed has died. Many of you, he's a longtime member here and a great guy, that I just wanted to pass that word along. I don't know anything about services or anything for him yet. I want to be in Job. We're going to be in Job chapter 12 and in verse 10, only one verse. And it goes like this, that it's a real powerful verse. And one of the things in Job, if you know the story, he's got friends that are giving him advice. And he doesn't buy into that advice for the most part. The advice is not very good. It's certainly not God's advice. And it's not, they're trying to tell him why these things are happening to him. And one of his response is this. He says, "For the life of every living thing is in his, God's, hand, and the breath of every human being." Imagine that, or just think about that. The breath of every human being, the life, every life is in God's hands. I know that, you know, when you sneeze, somebody will say, "God bless you." And the reason that they're saying that is because it was felt before that when you sneezed, that your breath that was from God breathing into you was leaving and you could die. And so you say, "God bless you," so you didn't die. So how does that relate to Christ? Well, really well. And I want to go to Colossians chapter 1 and read a part about what Colossians says that Jesus is. It says in verse 15 of chapter 1 of Colossians, it says, "Christ is the visible image of the invisible God. He existed before anything was created and is supreme over all creation. For through him God created everything in the heavenly realms and on earth. He made the things we can see and the things we can't see, such as thrones, kingdoms, rulers, and authorities in the unseen world. Everything was created through him and for him. He existed before anything else, and he holds all creation together. Christ is also the head of the church, which is his body. He is the beginning, supreme over all who rise from the dead. So he is first in everything."
Do you believe that? Is that something that you believe, that Christ was there at the creation of the world, that he was part of all creation, that he is in everything, that he is the center of all things? I believe that, but I'm not sure most of the world knows or understands or believes that. And that is such a powerful thing, you know, that this person, God, that Job was talking about way back is fulfilled in Jesus, that Jesus is God, basically, is what this text is saying. That's something to remember. You know, you have Christ in your heart and your life. You have the Holy Spirit in your life. There's no need for a temple anymore because your body is a temple. And so this, you know, the fact that God, the creator of the universe, that everything in the universe exists because of him and through him, is also in you, is powerful. And I would suggest that today you think about that, but also think about the fact that that power is available to you in all of your life, in every situation of your life. The power of the universe is available to you. And so I would encourage you to, in the old AA saying, to let go of yourself and your worries and your troubles today and let God take them. God bless and have a good day.